fantastic. Thanks, John. You know, the first game is never the same any year. It's always different, and you always kind of got to be on your toes.
Yep.
Rochester will go right to left on your radio dial. Eastbrook will go left to right. Rochester, black pants, white jerseys, black numbers, black helmets. Eastbrook, all black, with black helmets as well. Here's the kickoff. It's a short end-over-end kick. Going to come down to the up man for the Rochester Zebras, and that's Bennett. He takes it across the 30, down to around the 34-yard line, so that's where the Zebras will start. Here's their first possession of the 2014 season.
The starting lineup for the Rochester Zebras tonight, Sean Hunting is your quarterback, Wes Beck and Hashtell are in the backfield, Heckathorn is your flanker, Bennett and Shaney are split end and tight end, and the line is Schaefer, McLaughlin, Basham, Harper, and Adams.
72% humidity feels about like 1,000. Yeah, it is sticky, isn't it?
The Zebras come
to the line of scrimmage. They'll send a tight end tight to the right side. Then it goes split to the right side, which is the wide side of the field. I-backs for Hunting. Hunting under center. Heckathorn goes in motion to the right side. From the 34, the Zebras take the snap. Hunting gives it out to Shell Roth. The right side cuts back, lowers his head, falls to the 40, and that'll be a pickup of near 6 yards for the Rochester Zebras. That play went right, and he cut it back left and picked up 6.
Hadashell not exactly explosive coming out of the gate on that first play, but I'm guessing everybody just trying to get the feel of the turf underneath. Everybody's in tennis shoes.
I will take turf shoes. Unexplosive, non-explosive, and 6 yards every time.
Oh, absolutely.
High back formation, 2 tight ends for the Zebras. Heckathorn wide to the right side. Ball on the left hash. Hunting under center, takes a snap, gives to Hadashell again. Hadashell picking his way through traffic. Pushes his way across the 45-yard line, down to around the 49, and that'll be a Zebra first down after a pickup of near 9 yards. Give him 8, he'll be at the 48-yard line. One thing we're going to try to keep track of tonight is yards after contact for Jacob Hadashell. He had 1,600 yards last year for the Zebras. And am I safe to say 500 or more came after first contact? Would that be fair?
you could probably say that,
I think half?
Oh, definitely half.
Oh, yeah.
Lone back is Beck. 2 flankers for the Zebras. Bennett wide to the right side. Ball in the near hash. 1st and 10 from the Zebra 48-yard line. Heckathorn goes in motion right. Gets a jet sweep going right. Has a kick-out blocker by Heckathorn. He stops. Cuts back to the left side. Now in Eastbrook territory. Carries around the 45-yard line. And a nice, hard run by Jay Heckathorn off that right side. He had a great kick-out block out there by Hadashell.
As you listeners heard in pregame, the Eastbrook coaching staff had a hard time keeping up with the Yak, and that's put me in charge. So, hey, wish me luck.
I'm guessing it'll be an even tougher time. Give Heckathorn 7 on the carry. It'll be 2nd down and 3 for the Zebras now at the Panther 45-yard line. Ball in the far hash. The Zebras going to our left. Bennett wide to the near side. Tied in to the left side as well for the Rochester Zebras. Heckathorn is the flanker to the right. I-backs for Hunting. Hunting on 2nd and 3rd. Takes a snap from center. Hands off to Hadashell. Jacob stood up at the 45, maybe falls across to the 44. He gets a yard. It'll be 2nd down. Make that 3rd down and 2 for the Zebras. Not a lot there. Nice shot by the Eastbrook front 5. Bottling Hadashell up as soon as he got the football.
Yeah, the Rochester Zebra front line had been doing pretty well, getting some open holes for Hadashell to get through, and he was getting into the secondary for Eastbrook, but that time the black jerseys were able to close in quickly.
2nd and 2 for the Zebras at the Eastbrook 44-yard line. Bennett goes wide to the right side. Split backs now for the Zebras. Heckathorn, the flanker to the right side. Tight end right is Shane. Now he comes in motion to the near side. There's Shane. Comes set on the left side. Ball in the middle of the field. And now the Zebras will have to blow a timeout. 9:22 to play in the first quarter. Timeout on the field. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. On third and two, Heckethorn gets the pitch coming to the near side. Cuts it back inside. He's off to the races. Hit the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10. Touchdown, Zebras. Jay Heckethorn carries it 44 yards to put the Zebras on the board first. It's 6-0.
And a nice block by Jordan Schaefer about 20 yards downfield. He had a defender closing in on Heckethorn, and Schaefer did a good job of not hitting him in the back. He just kind of slid over sideways and bumped into
it. It scared me a little bit.
Enough to knock him down. The official was right next to him. He looked at him and let it go.
So that's going to send
Wilson Lee
out to do the extra point kicking. Brett Abbott is the holder. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is away. And it is good. The Zebras strike first. It's 7-0 with 9:14 to play in the first quarter. We'll take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. .44 to play in the first quarter. Jay Heckethorn scores on a 44-yard scamper. He broke a tackle with about 5 yards into the carry and outran the defense to the end zone.
Took the Zebras 6 plays, 2 minutes and 48 seconds, taking off the clock. Like Must said, 44-yard touchdown run by Heckethorn, and the PAT by Wilson Lee was good.
So the Zebras will kick into the sun. Back deep to receive the kick is Zach Martin and Luke Elliott for the Panthers. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman at Eastbrook High School. The Zebras up now 7-0. Wilson Lee approaches. High end over end, short kick. Received at the 25, runs backwards through the Panthers. Fakes the handoff, comes to their side, and fumbles the football. And the Zebras fall on it. Rochester falls on it inside the 15-yard line. And that's recovered by Thomas Rensberger. The Zebras in business again. Well, the Eastbrook Panthers try to reverse on the kickoff. It went fairly well. It was a fake reverse. It was hidden, and as the receiver was bringing it back to tuck it under and run, dropped the football. Rensberger right there, Johnny on the spot, recovers inside the 10 at the 8, first and goal for the Zebras.
Good job by Brett Abbott. Yeah, he didn't fall for that fake at all, so I think that's why that return was a little nervous there. He saw Abbott closing in on him.
So the Zebras, first and goal from the 8. They'll send Bennett wide to the near side, Shane tight right. Split backs for the Zebras. Heckethorn in the slot on the left side. Hunting under center. Hunting. Sends Heckethorn in motion. He gets the pitch going right. Kick out blocked by Heckethorn. Met in the backfield and drilled hard. Nothing there doing for Jay Heckethorn. And it will be second and goal for the Zebras from about the 8.
You going to make it? Computer glitches.
Really?
I lost everything we've done so far.
Really?
Yeah.
Is this the screen shut off?
So you're more than welcome to throw that.
That's all right. Okay. We'll figure it out.
That's how I usually handle it.
Well, I'm at a disadvantage. I don't have my mouse.
Second and goal from the 8 for the Zebras. High backs now for Rochester. Two tight ends. The flanker to the left side is Heckethorn. Hunting. With a play clock winding down to 0, and the Zebras will have to use their second timeout. We'll take one as well. You're listening to Zebra Football on 92.1 WROI. The Rochester Zebras are coming out of their second timeout, and we'll be looking at second down and goal from the 8-yard line. They're on the far side of the field, the short side of the field. Bennett is a tight end right. Looks like Kistler's tight end left. Heckethorn to the slot to the left side. Eyebacks for Hunting. Heckethorn now in motion to the right. Hunting takes the snap, gives to Hadashell going left. He's got a blocker. Hadashell tripped up right at the goal line, and at the end of the play, we have a flag on the play. Will that be a hold on Beck? Beck did not run into a defender until he was in the end zone.
I think they got out of his way.
It'll be a holding. Hold or blocking the back on the Zebras. Either way, it's moving the back, so it'll be second and goal from about the 19, maybe. That flag was thrown at the 9. No, I beg your pardon. That's going to be about the 17. Second and goal now for the Zebras at the 17-yard line. We have not seen a pass yet. This might be the opportunity to throw one.
Well, and I was just saying we haven't seen Wes Beck carry the ball yet either.
Right.
And Hodgeshell's been having a pretty good night running the ball. So
that is defensive guy on right now is about 3 inches, 4 inches smaller than him. So
10 on the play clock. Hunting from the 17 of Eastbrook, rolls right, looks back left. Here's a little screen. Gets to Hadashell. Jacob Hadashell down the near sideline. Cover behind and ripped out of bounds.
Out at the 5-yard line.
Giving 10 yards on the pitch and catch. It'll be third and goal from the 7. Under 8 minutes to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 7-0. And looking at third and goal from Eastbrook's 7-yard line. Ball in the near hash. Kistler brings the play in from the sideline. He'll come up tight to the left side. Heckethorn split left. Bennett split right. Split backs for Hunting with 10 seconds on the play clock. Hunting, bar singles. Here's a snap. Looks right. Throws it up in the back of the end zone. Bennett comes back to it. Touchdown, Zebras.
Nice job by Hunting getting the ball up so that Bennett can do the little jump play. Bennett trying to get a little separation. Maybe got away with a little push off, but I think the defender turned to the left. Bennett slid over to the right, was able to get the open pass.
Like I said, the play before, I think his defensive back is about 5'10", and Bennett's about 6'3", so it can't be easier than that.
So now it's 13-0, and Wilson Lee will come on to try to tack on the extra point with 7:51 to play in the first quarter. Here's a snap. His back, hold is down, kick is away, drifting right, drifting left, it is no good. 13-0 Rochester, 7:51 to play in the first quarter, 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Welcome back to Eastbrook High School. Well, the Zebras take advantage of a fumble recovery and score from 8 yards out to make it 13-0 on after a missed extra point by Wilson Lee.
Yep, it took 5 plays, 1:15, ran off the clock. Like you said, hunting the Bennett 7-yard touchdown, the PAT by Wilson Lee was no good.
7:51 to play in the first quarter. The Zebras have blown 2 timeouts here in this quarter. They're down to 1, and the Rochester Zebras will kick back into the sun. Back deep for Eastbrook will be Zach Barton and Luke Elliott. And I believe maybe the up man for Eastbrook on that far side last time received a punt. I don't know if that's 40 or 48 or what it is. I can't see the numbers
here. Yeah, black jerseys, black numbers.
Great numbers.
Tough.
Great
short
numbers. End over end kick. Drives the receiving team back at the 15, at the 20, the 25, right up the middle. And he is horse-collared.
Yeah.
By Brett Abbott,
we
and there's a flag in the play as well.
Flag coming in for targeting the head, I'm sure.
Yeah, that,
he's going to be a 15-yard unsportsman.
He like almost jumped for that tackle. He got him very high.
Nope, holding. What do we know? Holding against Eastbrook. Wow. I guess it wasn't as obvious down there.
Yeah, I guess that was obvious up here.
So, is it going to back up? The Panthers inside their 20-yard line back at the 17, and they'll start on the far hash going to our right. 13-0 Rochester, 7:45 to play And the first quarter.
Their first possession was a fumble, which the Zebras turned into points. And now their ensuing kickoff ends up in a costly penalty.
So Tyler Bennett brings the club to the line of scrimmage.
Oh, jeez.
Go to the wing tee type look. Oh, folks, hang with me. Bennett on the option. It keeps it. Heckenfor will make the out of shell, hits him first. Maybe a yard, not a lot there. It'll be second and long for the Eastbrook Panthers. This is going to be, this is going to be tough to see those numbers. Yep.
Yeah.
And then the hurry up.
Looks like the left slot back is Watson, makes Wallace the near side. And the no huddle, under center. Comes to the line of scrimmage with 15 on the play clock. On the option, the keeper again, left side. He's going to be wrapped and dropped. Another flag on the play.
There's a flag on the play. And I can't see who that was. 69. Jordan Schaefer, 58 for the Zebras. On the tackle, in the backfield.
So they lost yardage anyway. It'll be a hold on Eastbrook. It'll be declined, and it should bring up third down. Third down and what, maybe 11? The ball back at the 16-yard line. Started on the set. Well, no, maybe it's third and 9. Ball at the 16. Two wideouts to the near side for Eastbrook. Bennett has eyebacks. Yeah, they started at the 17. It's got to be third and 11, doesn't it? The ball is at the 16-yard line. You know, I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed. But
I'm keeping my mouth shut.
Yeah, easy there, Tiger, who hasn't had a...
You mute me too much.
According to the sticks on the sideline, no, it's third and 10.
All right, third and 10 for the Eastbrook Panthers. High back formation for Bennett. Two wideouts to the near side. On the option, gives the fullback right up the middle. And that's the big Luke Elliott. 5'10", 175 pounds, and picks up enough for a first down. He carries the ball across the 30, down to around the 33-yard line. That'll be enough for a Eastbrook Panther first down. I think everybody in the joint was expecting a pass, all except for the front line. And Bennett and then Elliott, who is at full speed as soon as he gets the football, is running downhill.
He's a big kid, 5'10", 175-pound fullback.
Bennett quickly, without a huddle. Gives to Watson on the near side. He's stacked up at the line of scrimmage and driven backwards.
I got six of them. Westbeck got him there first.
That'll bring up second down and 11 after a yard loss with 6.5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Again, the Zebras up 13-0. Bennett quickly under center. Gives the tailback.
And nothing there for the tailback. He's bottled up quickly by a number of white jerseys.
Actually, give that to fullback Luke Elliott.
Hadeshell and Schaefer among them.
He carries it out to the 34. Pick up a 3. It'll be 3rd and 8 quickly. Eastbrook on the ball again. Ball in the near hash again. The Panthers going to our right. Wing T formation. One wide out to the left side. Bennett gets a play from the sideline. Relays the play to the line of scrimmage with under 6 to play in the first quarter. Now under center with 10 on the play clock. Bennett. Takes the handoff, rolls to the left. Jordan giving chase, lost it up in the middle of the field. It's complete for Reese. He gets to that midfield. That's another first down for Eastbrook.
Fourteen yards on the pass play.
Good job by the Eastbrook off at the line there. And Bennett lost the time to throw. Schaefer is trying to get in. He's not having any of it.
Quickly on the ball are the Panthers from the 50-yard line, ball to the far hash. Watson gets the carry over the right side. Watson at the 45, grabs the tackler, moving to the 40-yard line, and that's going to be close to another Eastbrook first down. And as bad as this game started for the Panthers, boy, they have really rallied on this series.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like they're going to call time, and we'll have the sticks come across. And it's going to be really close to another Eastbrook first down. Regardless, it's going to be second and short if it isn't. But it doesn't look like it's going to be. I mean, I think they're just going to be a fuzz short, so it'll be second and inches for the Panthers. Now they're not going to call for the sticks. Back on the bar for the Panthers. Second and short. Bennett gives to Elliott. Elliott pushes his way across the 40, inside the 40, down to the 37. First down, Eastbrook. And I would yacht ride that young man all the way to the end zone. He is a load. 5'10", 175 pounds.
And he runs low to the ground.
Yeah. Quickly on the ball are the Panthers. Bennett gives Watson in motion, gives Elliott again, hit at the line of scrimmage, pushes his way forward, falls inside the 35, down to the 33-yard line.
You have him at 5'10", 175, and then we have Wes Beck at 6'1", 220.
Yeah.
I want to see his first.
Yeah, you're right. Quickly on the ball again to the Panthers. 20 on the play clock, the no-huddle offense. Watson in motion. Gives to Wallace left side. He is hit in the backfield and dropped.
Brought down by Adrian Harper. He was back there untouched real quick.
Yeah, he hit Elliott about the same, or Watson about the same time.
Uh-huh.
The ball got in his belly. So it'll be third down and about eight back at the 35-yard line for Eastbrook. Quickly on the ball again to the Panthers. Wide out to the near side. Wing T look for Bennett. Bennett gives to Watson on the jet sweep to the near side. He is stacked back by Hadashell. He is hit.
Yep.
A great open field tackle by Jacob Hadashell, who shoved off the block of Wallace and then single-handedly brought the running back down for a loss of yardage. It'll bring up fourth down and a long nine for Eastbrook. The ball will be at the Rochester 37-yard line. Under 4 minutes to play in the first quarter, 13-0 Rochester. Eastbrook will go for it on fourth and long. Bennett under center. Fakes the handoff. Back to pass. Looks left. Throws left. He's got a receiver. He's got racing over. Throws him. And complete. The Zebras will take over on down.
Wow.
Boy, they had him. Off
yeah,
the
had him wide open.
The tight end, Reese, was wide open again and just a fuzz too far. And Rochester will take over on down. It'll be first and 10 at their own 37-yard line. Now going to our left, which is right into the sun. 3:47 to play. In the first quarter, the Zebras up 13-0, and they'll get the ball back. Tippecanoe Valley and Culver Academy still not at a zero early in that game. Last report, Witco trails Wawa C 14-0, and McConaughey leads North Miami 7-0.
Crew Wabash for 0-0.
0-0, yep.
Wow.
So the Rochester Zebras with two tight ends come to the ball. Ball in the far near hash. Hunting under center. Heckathorn goes in motion right. High backs for John. Here's the snap. Gives it to the fullback, Beck. Beck, he's hit. He keeps his legs moving. He goes forward. He gets to the 40-yard line. Giving three, it'll be second and 7.
3 yards, but it took 7 of them to take him down.
But he, too, was hit at the line of scrimmage.
That's
true. Second down and 7. In an official timeout as Beck gets up. And what's he doing? Yep, lost the contact. He found it. Good for him. So he's trying to put that thing back in. The official's giving him some time. Ball will still be on the near hash. Again, Rochester going to our left.
And the sun setting right off
yeah.
the end of the scoreboard.
3:28 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up 13-0. Hunting gets the play from the sideline. Relays it to the team. Clock rolls. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering. I'm David Musselman. First game of the regular season. Last time we'll see John Glenn in the regular season. John Glenn.
Eastbrook.
What did I say, Eastbrook? Last time we'll see Eastbrook in the regular season. John
Glenn. He's going next year.
Yeah. High backs for Hunting. Two wideouts, one to each side. Hunting gives a handoff to Hadashell. Jacob Hadashell to the middle. Lowers his head at the 47. Falls to the 50. First down, Zebras.
10-yard run for Jake Hadashell. And I begin to wonder if anybody was going to catch him.
We still haven't seen him at full speed yet.
No.
Fellas, you want the bad news?
What's the bad news?
I was just nominated for the...
Why are you smiling?
Bucket challenge.
Good for you.
What are you laughing at? You're dead. 10 for the Zebras in midfield. Ball in the middle of the field. High backs for Hunting. Heckathorn in motion to the near side. Here's the snap. How to show again. Left side. Dodges one tackler, but not the other one.
Back to
and
line
he's going
to
lose a couple of feet. It'll be second and, we're going to say 11 for Rochester.
We can do that ice bucket challenge right after the game if you want.
Yeah,
there's
could.
A lot of Gatorade bottles
yeah,
out there.
We could, but I've got to go home.
You know you could just write a check.
you got to do both. $10 if you accept it, $100 if you decline it.
Second and 11 for the Zebras with clock rolls at 2:15 to play. In the first quarter, again, Rochester up 13-0. Quickly to the line of the Zebras with 4 on the play clock. 3-2-1. Here's the snap. Hunting keeps it, goes right. He's got a first down, lowers his head across, pulls across the 40. And what looked like a busted play from the word go as his left tackle was trying to pull and push him through the line of scrimmage.
Yeah.
He gets enough with a zebra first down and carries it out to the 38-yard line. Are you kidding me? Give him 12. Give him 13.
You don't often see a pulling tackle follow the ball through the hole.
Well, when you're down to one of the play clock, you got to make something happen quick.
Yeah.
Under 2 to play in the first quarter. Rochester has the football back into Eastbrook territory at their own 38-yard line. Hadashelle dots the I. Two tight ends for Rochester. Hunting under center. Hadashelle gets the carry. Gets a block in front of him by Beck. Directs traffic. Flag on the plate. Hadashelle still on his feet. Still pushing for yards. Gets it inside the 35. Down to around the 33. However, the flag on the field. More times than not, there's a holding in. That's what it is. So that flag was thrown at the 36. No, 34. Well, that should make it, yeah, about the second 14. Nope. Second 16, maybe. First, yeah. Thanks, Val. First and 16 for the Zebras. Now back at the Eastbrook 44-yard line. Down to 90 seconds to play in the first quarter. Again, Rochester up 13-0. Kistler and Heckenford go wide to the right side. Bennett split to the near side. Shotgun formation for John Hunting. Hunting back to pass. Looks left, throws down the middle of the field. Had finished, under threw him. It'll be second down and 16.
Got a good push from Eastbrook up through the middle, and Hunting not able to plant his feet and step forward into that pass.
Had Bennett on the slant.
Yeah.
Get it to him.
That ball is wobbly the whole way, though. Like you said, Bennett was on the slant. That could have went for six.
Yeah, if he'd had just another second or two to plant a seat and
step into it.
So CMA scores in the last seconds of the first quarter against Valley. They lead 6-0.
Here's a new look as well. Brett Abbott now, the wide out, going to the right side. Ball in the middle of the field. Zebras going to our left. With a minute 18 to play in the first quarter. They're looking at second down and 16 from the Panther 44. Hunting with Ivax behind him and two tight ends. Takes a snap. Pitches to Hadashelle. It's a ball of a fumble. Ball's loose. There's a scramble for it. It looks like the Zebras going to come up with it. But Eastbrook blew that play up as soon as that ball was snapped. Hadashelle lost his helmet. He'll have to come out. Heckenthorn will come in, and it'll be now third down and long back at the Zebra 48-yard line. That was ugly from the word go.
You got to think,
was that going to be a run for the backup quarterback to get the handoff, or was that going to be a pass around the near side?
I don't know, but whatever they were going to do with it, it was obvious that Eastbrook had seen that before, and they were not fooled in the slightest.
Abbott does have an arm, but with his speed as well, I think he's going to tuck it and go.
Third and 24, 35 seconds to play in the first quarter. Rochester at their own. No, this will be a screen. Rochester will be at their own 48-yard line. Shotgun again for Hunting. Two wideouts, one to each side. Here's the snap. Lowe picks it up. Throws down the middle of the field. It is incomplete off the hands of Bennett. And that'll bring up fourth down and 24 for the Zebras. And on comes the punting unit with 22 seconds to play in the first quarter. Boy, that series was a disaster from word go. They just kept going backwards.
Yeah.
So fourth and 24 for the Zebras. We'll get our first look at Jacob Hadashelle, who will put the ball away. Or is that Wes Beck?
Punting?
Yeah.
That's Wes Beck.
Beck is the punter. Back deep are the Panthers. Beck will punt from his 35-yard line. Snap goes all the way back to Beck. Gets it away. Nice spiral kick down the far side. Taking it to the 20-yard line. Makes a handoff around the near side. It's Bennett. Bennett stacked up at the 21 and nothing more. 12 seconds of play in the first quarter. Again, the Zebras are up by 13. And Eastbrook will take over at their own 21-yard line going to our right. Brad Thomas, Travis Watrings. I'm David Musselman. Alex Gunter comes on for the first time today offensively. He's 5'9", 215 pounds, and will be the fullback. Yikes. You thought Elliot was big. Good heavens. This cat's big. Now the new fullback is Alex Gunter. Bennett under center. Wallace goes in motion. Gunter gets to carry. Dragged about five Zebras with him. He gets hit at the 24-yard line and carries the Zebras down to the 29, and that'll do it for the first quarter. After one, the Zebras lead 13-0. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI. at Eastbrook High School, going to the second quarter. The Zebras leading 13-0. And we talked a little bit in the pregame about how nice this turf is for Eastbrook. They just got it in, and obviously playing on it tonight. We weren't sure because of all the rain they got down here, but you were able to post some pictures on the WRY Facebook page.
Yes,
they're on there if you want to see them. As we come back here to start the second quarter, Eastbrook's looking at first down and 10 at their own 31-yard line, ball in the near hash, and going to our left, wide to the far side is Deshaun, that is. Bennett sends Watson in motion. Keeper, quarterback keeper, ducks under the blockers around the right side. Not a whole lot there.
Harper was in there.
Give him one. It'll be second and 9.
Those pictures you posted, any of them selfies of you, Brad?
No, no. No, Lord, wouldn't want to do that.
We're trying to attract people to the website, the Facebook page.
Yeah.
Second and 9 for the Panthers at the 32. The wing back to the near side is Watson. The wing back to the far side is Wallace. Big fullback, I believe, is still Gunter. Watson gets the carry, sidesteps Beck, cuts it upfield. Gets a couple of positive yards. Spot on the near side is out to near the 33-yard line, 34-yard line. It'll bring up third and a long 7 for the Panthers with 11:15 to play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 13-0. Quickly on the ball is Eastbrook. And they adjust to the line of scrimmage. Deshaun goes wide to the right. Deshaun, that is, goes wide to the right side. Bennett under center. Watson in motion to the right. Comes back. Fake handoff. Rolls right as Bennett. Here comes a chase from behind him. Bennett will tuck and run. Bennett cuts it inside. He is hit from behind and dropped at the 40. And it's going to be fourth and short for Eastbrook at about the 40-yard line. They need to get to the 41 for a first down. I'm not sure who hit him and spun him around, but that saved a first down.
Yeah, it did.
And they'll go for it on their own 40. Eastbrook on the ball quickly. 20 on the play clock. Still directing traffic there on the line of scrimmage. Under center spin it. They'll go for it. They'll give it to Gunter. He has a first down and runs over a tackler on that far side and carries the ball out to the 44. It's enough for an Eastbrook first down and a chains move. Connor McLaughlin is who he hit hard, but fortunately for the Zebras, he held on and brought him down a little too late after he picked up about 4 yards on the carry. Quickly, Eastbrook on the ball. Bennett sets the line of scrimmage on first and 10. Tries to draw the Zebras offside. Pulls out from under center, looks over to the sideline, gets the play, now relays it with 15 on the play clock. Now ducks under, takes the snap from center. And Gunter right up the middle again, across the 45, near the 47, giving 3. It'll be second and 7 with 10 minutes of play in the first half. Again, Rochester leading 13-0.
Alex Gunter, he's big himself. 5'9", 215.
Yeah.
Wow.
What did the coaching staff for the Colts call Trent Richardson a bowling ball of 9.
Yeah. His thighs are about as big as.
Second and 7 for Eastbrook. At their own 47, Bennett quickly gives to the fullback again. And Gunter fights his way to the 50-yard line. And give him 3 more. It'll bring up 3rd and 4 for Eastbrook. Clock rolls down to 9:20 to play in the first half. At halftime, we'll have the recap of the first half. And, of course, like we did last year, it was the week it was in Rochester. We'll give you all the rundown of the results. I think most everybody, high school-wise, was in action this week for the Rochester Zebras. 3rd and 4 for the Panthers at midfield. 9 minutes to play in the first half. Been under center on the jet sweep. Wallace gets to the near side. Or is that Watson? Regardless, Watson carries, I believe Watson carries it over the 45, down to around the 44 of the Rochester Zebras, and that's enough for a first down. Hunting on the stop of the Rochester Zebras. The fullback still back there is Gunter. Tailback on the near side is Watson. Tailback to the right side, or the slot back, is Wallace. Bennett on the Rochester 44 gives to Gunter, bounces off of the tackler, driven backwards, and they're going to give him a line of scrimmage, and that's it.
Granted, the guest bleachers is very small, but it's full. Rochester brought in a decent little crowd.
A couple of scores to pass along to you. At halftime, West Central leading Culver 27-0. McConaughey leads North Miami 7-0. Whitco down to Wallasee 14-0. Second and 10 for Eastbrook. On the option, Gunter again off the right side, pushes his way forward, giving the 41-yard line. Pick up a three. It'll be third and 7 for Eastbrook. Ball for Rochester, 41-yard line. Again, Eastbrook going to our left, right into the sun. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Third and 7 for Eastbrook. Tyler Bennett, the junior quarterback, looks to the sideline, has his play. Sean White on the near side. Watson goes in motion right. Back to pass is Bennett. Makes the pass. Steps up. Now he's going to keep it. He runs left. Smith is one tackle. And Speck and Schaefer come in flying from behind, drop him at the 39. That's going to bring a fourth down, but more importantly, up. So it'll be fourth and about 5 for Eastbrook. Balls at the Rochester 39-yard line. 7:25 to play in the first half. And it looks like Eastbrook will get over the ball and look to go for it. Fourth and 5 for the Panthers at the Rochester 39. Watson has a motion on the near side. And then the other receivers fall on it. Rochester falls on the fumble at the 41-yard line. And again, Eastbrook drives stalls. Catch that number.
That foul. Wilson Lee recovered. Thanks, Val.
Unheard
eyes.
Rochester Sentinel. Yeah. So, an official timeout. I think the fellas are going to get some water. So, Rochester holds Eastbrook again on downs and will take over at their own 41-yard line, leading 13-0 with 7:12 to play in the first half. So, Brad, let's go back to Eastbrook's page a little bit. Luke Elliott started as the fullback, and then Alex Gunter comes in, and I've got to believe that most of the carries have been from the fullback position.
Yeah, I had Elliott for 4 carries, 17 yards, and Gunter's got 4 carries for 18 yards, and that's the bulk of their yardage so far.
Some scores from around the area. Winnemac leads Knox 7-0 in the first quarter. Manchester 14, Mississippi 13 in the second.
Next week's opponent, Plymouth, leads Bremen at the end of the first, 7-0.
Again, this is the last time we will see Eastbrook in the regular season. Next year, we'll travel to John Glenn. So next year, the first non-conference games for the Rochester Zebras will be on the road. I'm hoping the Witto game will be at home.
Yeah, John Glenn on the road, Plymouth on the road. Yeah.
So Rochester, first and 10 at their own 42-yard line, going to our right. Two receivers to the left, a tight end to the right. That's Shane Ibacks for Hunting. John Hunting under center, takes a snap, gives the handoff to Heckathorn, right up the middle. Jacob Heckathorn.
That's Hadashell.
Or makes it Hadashell, still on his feet at the 30. Carries a couple of tacklers inside the 25, down to around the 22. A huge pickup for Jacob Hadashell. And the Zebras are in business again, giving the 21.
37 yards.
Hadashell, a huge carry, a great push up front by the Zebras, and of course, following Big West Beck.
Yeah. Definitely going to get some big holes behind him. And that time we saw some speed from Jacob Hadashell.
Yeah.
Some yak yards as well. Yeah, hit some early.
Multiple times, yeah.
Bennett split left. Abbott wide to the near side. High backs for Hunting from the 21 of Eastbrook. Hadashell again, right side. Hadashell across the line of scrimmage, lowers his head at the 10, pushes his way ahead. The 15, and gets out to about the 12. Looks like about 8, maybe. 6:35 to play in the first half. Rochester up 13-0 and knocking on the door again. Giving the 12, it'll be second down and 1 after a 9-yard pickup. 4, Hadashell. That's all it's been on this drive is Jacob Hadashell.
You're right. 2 carries.
Not broke, don't fix it.
Right on. Hadashell loses his helmet again. Wilson Lee now will come on and run for the Rochester Zebras. He will be the tailback. 15 on the play clock. Quickly, the Zebras on the ball. Abbott and Bennett wide to the near side. Shane tight end left. Down to 5 on the play clock. Hunting quickly gives it back, who is the tailback. Wes Beck looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Zebras.
Wes Beck not going to be denied.
So Wes Beck, running behind Lee that time, scores on a 21-yard run, make that a 12-yard run to put the Zebras up 19-0. With 5:52 to play in the second quarter, Lee will attempt the extra point with Brett Abbott holding. Schaefer, the long snapper. Down to 15 on the play clock. Snap is back. Hold is down. Here comes some pressure. Lee gets it away, and it looks right down the middle. It is. 5:52 to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Welcome back to Eastbrook High School, 5:52 to play in the first half of the Zebra strike again.
Yep, three plays, a minute 15, taken off the clock. West Beck, 12-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebra's lead, 20-0.
And, Brad, I think that you hit it on the head. That's two touchdowns off of two turnovers.
Yeah. The one was deep in Eastbrook territory. Rochester able to score on that one in the ensuing drive. And then this one, the turnover coming at midfield, and the Zebras turning that into a score in, what'd you say, four plays, three plays?
Three plays, yeah. How to shell back.
Yep.
Martin and Elliott back deep to receive the Wilson Lee kick. End over end kick. Martin picks it up at the 20 with a full head of steam at the 25, cuts back to the middle of the field at the 30. Dodges one tackler to the 25 and hauls a group of Zebras across the 35 to the 36-yard line. So a pretty good return of about 16 yards, gets Eastbrook the ball at their own 36 in the middle of the field, going to the left. 5:46 to play in the first half. Zebras up 20-0. Wide on the near side is Reese. Wide on the far side is Deshaun. Shotgun formation for Bennett. Takes a snap on the draw. Gives the fullback. He carries the ball out to the Eastbrook 40, giving the 40-yard line. Picks up four, and that was Elliott who carried the football that time for the Panthers. They'll stay in the shotgun formation. Three receivers to make that two receivers to the near side, one to the far. Elliott is to the left of Bennett, who's in the shotgun on second down and six. Again, Elliott gets a carry, and he drops behind the 40.
Great job by Wilson Lee to get in the backfield real quick.
Loses one. It'll be third and seven with 5:10 to play in the first half. Quickly, Eastbrook on the ball again. Reese wide to the near side. Spot to the left is Watson. Shotgun again for Bennett with Elliott to his left. On third down and seven, Bennett takes the snap and gets it through his hand. He picks it up, and here comes the Zebras and drops him for a loss.
So Wilson Lee. Yep. Right on top.
Gets a sack.
Jordan Schaefer there as well.
And pushes the ball back to the 30-yard line. That's going to bring up fourth down and 16 for the Panthers.
Maybe the punting unit.
And it looks like Bennett will come off the field and the punters will come on. Luke Elliott is the punter. He stands back at his 20. Jay Heckathorne stands back at his 40 to receive the kick with 4:15 to play in the first half. Snap goes to Elliott. No pressure. Gets it away. High end-over-end kick. Heckathorn grabs it at the 39, and right up the middle it goes. Heckathorn dodges the tackler at the 50, the 45, the 40. Down the far sideline at the 30. He's at the 25, the 20. He's going to the end zone. Touchdown. Zebras
got a
flag on the play.
Flag back almost midfield.
Zahner not happy. I don't know who he's not happy with. I don't think it was the individual they're going to whistle that against. I'm thinking maybe it's the official on that far side. Man, maybe not.
No, Daniel looks fired up at one of the players. Well.
So this is exactly what Coach Zahner told me in the pregame. I just hope that Heckathorn can get his hands on it and make something happen. And regardless of the flag, that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, you're right. He did. He had a great lane. He got good blocking down that sideline. I think the penalty came after Heckathorn went by. Heckathorn was already going down
the sideline,
so
and the penalty was behind him.
That's tough.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, we know. I know that you want to do everything you can to help the your.
Well, and I mean, it wasn't like it was just behind him. He was crossing the 20, and the penalty was that the flag was thrown at the 40. So there was really no call for the penalty. And
so it'll be first and 10 for the Zebras at midfield, going to our right ball on the far hash.
Okay, thanks.
Make that Bennett tied to the right. The slot man to the far side is Abbott, I-backs for Hunting. Abbott comes in motion to the near side with 3:56 to play in the first quarter. Had a shell to carry, wrapped up in the backfield. Backs his way across the 50 to the 49. What could have been a 3-yard loss turns into a 1-yard gain. And that would be 3 on the yak.
Thank you.
Actually, give him the 48 rather than gain of 2. It'll be 2nd and 8. With 3.5 minutes to play in the first half, again, Rochester up 20-0. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. Halftime show coming up. We'll recap the first half and have the week that was in Rochester athletics as well here in about 3.5 minutes. Bennett wide to the far side, short side of the field. Abbott split to the near side, wide side. Eye backs for Hunting. Quickly the snap. How to show again, right side. Cuts it outside. Falls across the 45, down to around the 43. A pickup of near 5 yards. And they'll bring up 3rd down and 3 for the Zebras with 3 minutes of play in the first half. Boy, the line of scrimmage is winning the war up front right now, aren't they?
Yeah.
Or the offensive line, I should say.
Schaefer and Adams at your tackle, Harper and McLaughlin at your guards, and Adam Basham, your center, doing that phenomenal job.
Two wideouts on the near side for Rochester. Ball in the middle of the field and 3rd and 3. How does Shell again make that Beck? Beck right up the middle! And Westbeck cut down at the 35-yard line, 1st and 10, Zebras.
I think he kind of stepped on one of the Eastbrook defenders had he not, if he'd have been able to keep his feet. I don't think anybody would have stopped him.
1st and 10 for Rochester at Eastbrook's 35-yard line. 2.5 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester up 20-0. And they break the line of scrimmage with the ball in the middle of the field. They'll send Bennett wide to the near side. Brett Abbott split left. 2 tight ends for Rochester. And IMAX for Hunting from the 35 of the Panthers. Hunting takes the snap. Beck again, left side. Westbeck, huge hole in the middle. Westbeck is ankles tackled at the 20-yard line. He falls inside the 20, down to around the 15. Giving 15 yards.
That was a great run by Westbeck, but he got caught from behind by the at the ankles.
Giving 20, Bradley. Giving 20 yards. It'll be 1st and 10. For the Z's at the Eastbrook 15-yard line, ball on the far hash. Shane, tight left. Bennett wide to the near side, which is the wide side of the field. Heckathorn split left, split backs for Hunting. From the 15 of Eastbrook with 15 seconds to play on the game clock. Here's the snap. Back again, left side, and nobody fooled there. Swarm of black in to cut him down back at the 16. He's going to lose a yard. That'll bring up 2nd and 11 with 1:45 to play in the first half here at Eastbrook High School. 2nd and 11 for the Zebras on the far hash. Rochester going to our right. 20 on the play clock. The Zebras break the huddle. They'll send Bennett wide to the near side. Heckathorn to the short side of the field. Split out. Eye backs again for Hunting. Back to pass is Hunting. In the middle of the field is Bennett. Complete. Bennett stretches for the end zone, and he's brought down at the 1. So it'll be 1st and goal for the Zebras down at the 1. A great pitch and catch from Hunting to Bennett, who, again, on that slant play, was wide open.
Bennett did all he could to try and hit in the end zone. He reached out there and stretched. As soon as the ball hit the ground, though, it popped free. They ruled him down at the 1.
A 15-yard pitch and catch from Hunting to Bennett. And it is 1st and goal for the Zebras at the 1. Full house backfield. Straight team backs, Heckathorn, Beck, and Hadashell left to right. Hunting under center, gives to Hadashell, going left, lunges for the goal line. Touchdown, Zebras!
Just your run-of-the-mill, hard-nosed run by Hadashell. He only needed a yard. He just put his head down and kept pushing until he finally crossed that goal line.
And the Zebras hit the end zone again with 62 seconds to play in the first half, making the score 26-0. And the extra point team coming on, looking to tack on a point. Wilson Lee will do that. Basically a straightaway kicker with Abbott holding. Schaefer, your long snapper. He's over the football right now. Snapped it back, hold it down. The kick is away, and it hits the right upright, no good. 26-0 Zebras. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI.
That's what I heard.
Welcome back to Eastbrook High School. A minute two to play in the first half, and the Zebras in the end zone again.
Eight plays, and 3 minutes taken off the clock, capped off by Jacob Hadeshell, 1 yard touchdown. The PAT by Wilson Lee was so good. Zebras lead 26-0.
And let me make something clear that we say a 1 yard touchdown, but he had run hard to get that.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, they stacked him up right at the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, they did. T back with Heckenthorn and Beck back there. They all three had to fight for that touchdown.
Yeah. Wilson Lee to kick. End-over-end kick, short end-over-end kick. Bounces at the 25-yard line, picked up on the bounce. Ball brought to back to the 30, looking for some room to run, and he is stacked up, but pushes the pile forward to around the 34. Well, that's where Eastbrook will start this drive with all three timeouts left, by the way, with 54.8 seconds to play in the first half.
I got a house show with 69 yards here in the first half.
Scores coming up at halftime from around the area. We'll recap the first half as well. And the week that was in Rochester Athletics coming up here at the break. Been under center. I believe that's Elliott in the backfield. And Rochester will, Rochester will use their final timeout of the half. We'll take one as well. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WROI. At Eastbrook High School, 54.8 to play in the first half. The Panthers with the football on their own 34-yard line. I believe Elliott gets the carry right up the middle, pushes away across the 35, maybe to the 36. Not a lot there. Yeah, it was Elliott. He gets two. It'll be second down and eight. Clock rolls under 40 seconds to play in the first half. Again, Rochester up 26-0. Quickly on the ball are the Panthers. Bennett under center. Watson, the slot back to the left. Wallace comes in motion to the near side. Right in the middle again is Elliott.
Wow.
He is hit after about a 3 yard gain. We're down to 20 seconds of play.
Harper right
in the first
there.
Half.
Harper planting him into the ground.
Ball now at the 38 of Eastbrook. Up the middle of the field. Third and six for the Panthers. Under 10 seconds of play. Down to seven. Down to five. Motion man is Wallace. Watson gets the carry going right. Watson is hit and spun away from a tackler. Keeps his feet, driven out of bounds, and that'll do it for the first half. At halftime, the Zebras lead 26-0. Halftime report coming up next on 92.1 WROI.
Starts, but like we said, Coach Sander loves his goose eggs. He's going to hope for the opposite.
So back deep to receive the kick. For the Eastbrook Panthers will be Martin and Elliott. Oh. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering, I'm David Musselman. We are ready for the second half at Eastbrook. Again, the Zebras will kick. Wilson Lee will do the honors. He gets the green light, and here we go. He'll put a right foot into it. Short end-over-end kick. Going to come down to Martin. Martin at the 22, and his knee hits the ground at the 22, 23-yard line. So there was no return put on, giving the 24. It'll be first and 10 for the Panthers at their own 24. Ball in the far hash.
We got a halftime score from Tippecanoe Valley, or from CMA. It's 14-7 CMA.
14-7?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Scored and went for two.
Uh-huh.
That would make up the 8-point difference.
Yeah. Good, man.
Spin it under center. Watson goes in motion, gives to the fullback, Elliott. Elliott over the right side, pushes his way across the 30, down to around the 31, maybe the 32. That's close. A nice run by the fullback and Luke Elliott, and he picks up about 7 yards. He'll bring up third, make that second and three for the Panthers. Quickly on the ball, Elliott again going right. He's got a first down, and he's tackled at 36. First and 10, Panthers.
Give Elliott about 5-4 yards, yak yards.
Yeah, right. And again, Eastbrook on the ball. Wide out to the near side. Which is Deshaun. Watson, the tailback to the near side. He goes in motion to the right side. Wallace gets the carry. And Wallace carries the ball for 2 or 3 yards, maybe 3 yards out to the 39. Giving three, it'll be second and 7. And quickly on the ball again are the Panthers. This is exactly what I was worried about here. And they are full throttle right now, down 26-0. Obviously, there's an emergency for them. But they're moving quite quickly on second and 3. Back to pass. Is Bennett right to the near side. Throws down the middle of the field, complete to Reese. And Reese catches it in Rochester territory, giving the 48.
Hey, Coach Zahner actually already made some subs on defense. Number 4, I don't have the roster, is out there. And then John Hunting, actually the quarterback, is playing corner as well.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it started out Bennett, Kistler, and Abbott.
First and 10 for Eastbrook. Elliott again right off the right side. He's got a huge hole, carries the ball to the 40, inside the 40 to the 39. And that'll give him 8 yards, and it'll be a pickup, make that second and 2. After the quick hitter again, quickly in the ball to the Panthers. Second and 2 for the Bennett. Watson on motion. Fullback Elliott carries the ball right. Carries the ball inside the Rochester 35 to the 34. First down for Eastbrook. 10-20 to play in the third. Rochester up 26-0. Eastbrook knocking on the door here. Ball's inside the Rochester 35. Give him the 34. Tyler Bennett under center. Wing T behind him. Watson goes in motion right on the jet sweep. Wallace gets it coming around the near side. He lunges forward to the 30, giving 4. It'll be 2nd and 6. Deshaun wide to the near side for Eastbrook. Bennett has the play from the sideline. Relays it to the line of scrimmage. On 2nd and 6, Watson goes in motion to the right side on the option. The keeper by the quarterback, Bennett, then flips it out, and then there's a fumble. Ball's loose. The Zebras say they have it, and they do.
Wow. He could have just held on to that football and gained 10 yards.
He had gained 10 yards.
Yeah. I don't understand what he's trying to do.
Well, the pitch man was open, granted. But, boy, that pitch was 3 feet over his head.
He did a great job. Watson tried to bring that back in, but that was just too tall for him to handle. And the Zebras right there to pick up the fumble, and they'll start at their own 23-yard line for the first time this half, going to our right. First and 10 for the Z's. Bennett goes wide to the left side. Heckethorn wide to the near side. Shane is tight right. And eye backs for John Hunting. From his own 23, ball in the far hash. Hunting takes the center. The snap, that is. Gives to Hadashell. Picks his way through the defense. Hadashell turns on the afterburners and gets out to the 30. Giving 7. It'll bring up 2nd down and 3 for Rochester. With 9:35 to play in the third quarter, leading 26-0.
Great job by the Rochester line. Picking that blitz up, that center blitz, and pushing it to the right side so the house shell can break off to the left and gain
right.
The 7 yards.
So Rochester will probably use a lot of the play clock here to get the play off. We're down to 15. They're on the line of scrimmage. I-backs for Hunting. From the 30 of the Rochester Zebras, and 2nd down and 4, gives the house shell again going left. Jacob house shell runs over a couple of tacklers, gets it inside the 40. Down around the 41, giving 11 yards, and another Zebra first down.
Almost looked like Eastbrook didn't realize Hadashell had the football. He just kind of come flying out of that line and ran straight into the safety, who wasn't really in a tackling position. He was kind of just standing there.
Hattishell's tired. I'm telling you, he gets up, and, you know, it's one of those walk backs with his hands on his hips and his head flipped back looking at the stars.
But we've seen games like that last year where he looks tired and he still runs for another 100 yards.
First and 10 for the Z's, down to 10 on the play clock. Heckathorn wide to the near side. Bennett split left. Lone back is Westbeck. Hattishell has the carry. Hattishell down the near sideline. Cuts it back inside of the 30, the 25, the 20, the 15, the 10. Looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Sabres.
And a great block by Bennett about 30 yards downfield to take the safety out of the middle of the field. And Hattishell, dancing around that defense of Eastbrook, is able to cut back in behind what the Bennett's block. And that's what got him to the end zone.
A 59-yard touchdown run for Jacob Hattishell put the Zebras up 32-0 with the extra point coming with an 8:38 to play in the third quarter. Kicker is Lee. Snap is back. Hold is down. Kick is away. It's a low kick. Does it make it? It does. 33-0 Rochester. Take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. To play in the third quarter, the Rochester Zebras strike again.
Yeah, it took three plays, a minute 12, ticking off the clock, capped off by a Jacob Hattishell, 59-yard touchdown run. The PAT by Wilson Lee was good. Zebras lead 33-0.
Tell me again how tired he looks.
Yeah, he looks gassed. He's well on his way to that 1,600-yard mark, isn't he?
Yeah, he's got 146 now.
Wilson Lee, a high end over end kick, short, taken by the up man to the 33, and he is pushed backwards at about the 36. 7-yard line, so it'll be first and 10 for Eastbrook at their own 37, going to our left with 8.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Brad Thomas, Travis Watchering, I'm David Musselman.
I've got Eastbrook for 97 yards rushing as a team. I've got them for 128 yards total. Hattishell has 146 by himself.
Wow. I tell you what, every time that they attempt to pass to Reese, he's open.
Yeah.
Every time, he's only dropped one, and that was just because it was off his fingertips and too long. But he was open on that pass play, too.
Three fumbles by Eastbrook have all turned into points for Rochester.
First and 10 for the Panthers with own 37. Elliott off the left side. Carries the ball for about 6 or 7 yards. Takes it down to their own 44-yard line.
John Hunting on the tackle for the Zebras.
Second and 2 for the Eastbrook Panthers. Wallace comes in motion to the near side. Elliott again, left side, tripped up at the 45, and that's it. Give him a yard. It'll bring up 3rd and 4. Jordan Schaefer on the tackle there for the Rochester Zebras. Ball to the Eastbrook 45, near hash, one left, 3rd and 2 for the Panthers. Deshaun wide to the near side. Your fullback in the game still is Elliott. Then it comes in, fakes the handoff, gives off to Wallace, and Wallace gets close to the marker.
And then smashed by Wilson Lee at the end.
I thought Rochester did a great job by taking Elliott out of that play, and an even better job by Tyler Bennett recognizing that, pulling it out of the belly of Elliott and giving it to Wallace, and picked up just enough for an Eastbrook first down. 1st and 10 for the Panthers at their own 47-yard line. It was 7:40 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up 33-0. Bennett under center. Watson goes in motion right. Here's the carry. Watson gets it going right. Cuts it back inside. Now pops it back outside at the 45, the 40. Down the far sideline at the 35. And dragged down from behind at about the 33-yard line. Again, Rochester in, taking Elliott out of the play. Bennett doing a great job recognizing that, pulling that out of the belly of Elliott, giving it that time to Watson, who did the rest himself. Is there a flag on the play?
Got a flag, yeah.
I don't see a flag.
After an 18-yard gain. We're going to have... What was that? A fist straight out, straight on.
He pointed at someone.
What was that? Well, they're talking to Eastbrook, so it must be against Rochester.
Well,
wait a minute. They're bringing the
maybe
going on. They're bringing the ball back. Give us a signal. So they're bringing the ball back.
Read?
They said dead ball.
Did they redo?
I think they did say a redo.
Call it a dead ball.
All right.
Oh, they blew the play dead before the.
Uh huh.
Good for us.
Well, let's hope that pays
boy,
off. That's... So first and 10, Elliott again, fakes the handoff, Bennett keeps it, and is driven backwards.
Schaefer on the tackle?
Yep, and he is spun down back at the 41-yard line. Nope, they're going to say his momentum stopped at the 43.
Wow, that turned into like a 24-yard loss.
Yeah,
you're right. The official blew that play dead because he thought the fullback had the ball. In reality, it went for 20 yards. They lost that.
So now it'll be second and 15 for Eastbrook at their own 43. Back to pass is Bennett. Here comes some pressure. Beck giving chase. Bennett throws it back across his body. He's complete to Reed. What a fantastic catch.
Almost.
Is that Reed? Yeah.
Wow, what a catch.
You know, you always hear the guys on Sunday say, never, 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 never throw back across your body in the middle of the field. That time it paid off for Bennett.
Reese made him look pretty good, too.
Yeah, and he picked up 12 yards on play. It'll bring third down and 4 for Eastbrook at the Rochester 47.
I thought he was throwing that right into the Rochester defender.
Yeah.
Reese made a great catch.
Third and 4 for Eastbrook. Here comes some pressure. Back to passes. Bennett rolls to the near side. Throws complete to Elliott. Elliott inside the Rochester 30, down to around the 26, 25-yard line, giving the 26 first and 10 for Eastbrook. I think they might have found something.
Well, there wasn't a zebra within 10 yards of him when he caught the ball.
Yeah.
Out of the backfield.
Well, give him 21 yards. Down to the Rochester 26.
They only passed the ball two times for a half. We're not used to this.
Yeah. Watson in motion right on the keeper. Bennett goes to the right side. Decides not to pitch it. Keeps it and is stopped at the 25. Give him a yard. It'll be second down and 9 with 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 33 to nothing.
That's probably a good idea not to pitch it.
Yeah.
Well, you can tell he's a little gun-shy there. What,
yeah. I'm guessing he got a little coaching on the sideline.
Second and 9 for Eastbrook at the Rochester 25-yard line. Quickly, Bennett under center. Watson goes in motion to the right. On the end around is Wallace. Wallace stripped up at the 20. Balls across the 20 to the 19. That'll be a pickup of about 6 or 7. That'll bring up third down and about 3 for Eastbrook, who's, again, quickly on the ball. They went without a huddle this entire football game. 5:25 to play in the third. Third and 3 for Eastbrook, the Rochester 19. Bennett tries to draw the Zebras upside, and he does so. First and 10, Rochester. I'm sorry, first and 10, Eastbrook.
It's our fourth penalty of the night, I think.
That'll move the ball inside the 15-yard line to the 14 and give the Eastbrook Panthers a new set of downs. And looking for their first score of the evening. 5:15 to play in the third. Bennett and the Panthers quickly on the ball. Ball comes in motion to the near side. The fullback gets the carry. Elliott up the left side of the line of scrimmage. Inside the 10, down to around the 9.
I'd just ride Elliott all the way to the goal line.
Absolutely. I would, too. Second and 4 for the Panthers. Ball inside the 10 of the Rochester Zebras. Bennett again quickly. Watson motion to the right side. Elliott again right side. Elliott looking for the end zone. Spun around, drop flag on the play. Elliott carried the ball out to the 5-yard line, but let's see what the flag is. Connor McLaughlin on the stop for the Rochester Zebras. 4:46 to play in the third quarter. Again, Rochester up 33 to nothing. And we're going to have a hold on the Eastbrook Panthers, so that's going to drive them back 10.
Those kind of penalties hurt you when you get down inside your opponent's 10-yard line.
Yeah.
Takes that play away and makes it more difficult on a short field.
Marches it back to the 18.
Second down, looks like about 14 yards for Eastbrook. Back to the Rochester 18-yard line with 4:40 to play in the third quarter. Bennett for Eastbrook. Mark signals. Steps up under center with 10 on the play clock. Takes the snap. Fakes the handoff. Here comes some pressure. Here comes some defensive pressure. And he's brought by Heckathorn back to the 29-yard line.
Great job by Heckathorn. He just broke off the corner and was right on Elliott before he could peel away.
Loss of 11 yards on the play, and that's going to push Eastbrook back to third and 24 with 4:10 to play in the third quarter. Again, right on the Rochester 29-yard line.
Unofficially, I think that's maybe three, four sacks for them tonight.
Yeah. Three wideouts for Eastbrook. Three to the right, one to the near side. Bennett will be under center with Elliott behind him with 7 on the play clock. Back to pass, and here comes the trick. Oh, Heckathorn sacked
him. Another corner blitz from Heckathorn, untouched, and hits Bennett from behind. He never even saw him coming.
Loses 7 more yards. It'll bring up fourth down and about 31 from the Rochester 36-yard line, and Eastbrook will have to go for it with 3:20 to play in the third quarter, down 33-0.
So they had first and goal from, what, the 7?
They had a first and 4 at the 7, I think.
Yeah.
Bennett back to pass. Here comes the pressure. Get it! Heckathorn again! He's dropped for a sack!
Jeez. Three straight plays by Heckathorn.
When you
Bennett,
all the people.
Bennett getting up very slowly. You know, he took a thump that last time, and then this time he got smoked again, and he's hurting.
Hey, when are they going to learn how to – Heckathorn's good.
Well, he's like 23.
Heckathorn just gained 24 yards playing defense.
Yeah, you won't read that. You won't play that
in a row.
Yeah. So Rochester will take over on downs at their own 42-yard line. Ball to far hash. They'll go to our right. 3:16 to play in the third. Rochester up 33-0. Abbott comes wide to the near side. Bennett is split left, which is the short side of the field. Split backs for Rochester. And Shane is the tight end to the right. Hunting to Beck. West Beck, stiff arm, loses the football, and does it go out of bounds? It does.
Yep, he's lucky.
Yeah,
it goes out of bounds, and it goes out of bounds at the Eastbrook 49-yard line, so he's going to pick up about 9 yards on the play.
He picked up 7, and the ball bounced 2 more.
So it'll be second down and 1.
He is lucky, though, because Eastbrook was all over that ball.
Yeah, he was.
If. Out of bounds it.
Well, Rochester's had one fumble, and they were able to recover it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I don't think that's going to be something that Mike Zahner wants to see ever, is that ball hit the ground. And there's going to be some things to work on next week leading into Plymouth.
Especially Eastbrook has 3 fumbles, and they all turned into touchdowns. So.
Second and 1 for the Zebras at the Eastbrook 49. Hunting, snap. Heckathorn bounces off and make the house shell bounces off a 12th players and followed up right at the line of scrimmage. Nothing there. It'll be third down and 1 for Rochester. Under 3 minutes of play in the third quarter, the Zebras leading 33-0. Hanischel is down. Still getting up. He'll get up now.
Yeah. Well, now it's when you start to see things cramping.
Yeah.
You know,
you can see a little limp on him.
Yeah.
Maybe his right foot.
He does stay in the game. Goes back to the huddle. Zebras quickly on the ball. 3rd and inches.
You know what? It's probably going back to him.
I don't know. Might you just hunt and keep it here? Unless he put 11 guys in the box, which they're doing.
Give it the back. He's 220 pounds.
Here's the carry. Hanischel again, left side. Hanischel has the first down, pushes his way to the 45, and gives the Zebras new life at the Eastbrook 45-yard line. The 2:25 to play in the third quarter, leading 33-0.
There's Hanischel with 152 yards.
And there's the cramping beginning. Yeah. Hanischel grabbing his calf. Left calf.
Yep.
So let's take an injury timeout. It's going to be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Eastbrook High School. Rochester looking at first and 10 at the Eastbrook 45-yard line. Beck right up the middle. West Beck runs over a couple of tacklers, spins his way across the 40, inside the 40-yard line. And as we were away there, we knew Jacob Hadeshell. That's why we went to break. Jacob Hadeshell had a cramp. And as we were in commercial break, another zebra fell with some big cramps.
Yeah, Adrian Harper, I think he was running through the sideline and literally just fell down on the ground. So he had a bad cramp as well.
Two hammy cramps, and both calves are cramping, it looks like, from here.
And yeah. They're both going both ways.
Yeah.
So get them out for a little bit.
Yeah, they'll be in an ice bath.
So the new, I think, Tanner Lee or
Wilson Lee
is the tailback in the backfield for Rochester. Split backs now on second down and 3. Beck again. Beck hit the line of scrimmage and picks up positive yards to get close to the first down, giving 2. It'll be 3rd and 1. With 1:20 to play in the third quarter, again, Rochester up 33-0.
So unofficially, I had Hadeshell with 14 carries for 152 yards and 2 touchdowns.
I don't think he's done yet.
I don't either.
That's a pretty good night.
Pretty
clock good. Rolls with 1 minute to play in the third quarter. Rochester looking at 3rd down and 1 from the Eastbrook 34-yard line. Rochester taking a lot of time here to get out of the huddle. They'll do so with about 7 on the play clock. Rochester gets to the line of scrimmage with 4, with 3, straight T backfield with 1. Here's a snap, Hunting right up the middle, and John Hunting carries the ball for 2 yards and a zebra first down, giving 3 yards and a zebra first down as he carries to the 34 of the Panthers.
Well, it looks like Hadeshell's actually on the ground again. Well, hey, it's some one of those two. I can't tell which one. Maybe they are done for the night.
44 seconds to play in the third quarter. Rochester has it 1st and 10 at the Eastbrook 34-yard line, going to our right. Rochester in the middle of the field. Heckathorn is the flanker to the right side. I-backs for the Zebras. Hunting under center on 1st and 10. Hunting with 2 tight ends, long count, gives to Heckathorn going left.
Fumble.
And fumbles the football. Ball loose. There's a scramble for it. And
Rochester says they got it.
I think the officials are. Okay, Rochester recovers.
Jeez.
And we'll see who the guy on the bottom of that pile was.
77. Sam Adams.
Sam Adams there to recover the the fumble, and in the meantime, Rochester picks up 6 yards. Will bring up 2nd down and 4, and that'll do it for the third quarter. After 3, Rochester leading 33-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Back at Eastbrook High School, we're going to the 4th and final quarter right now. The Zebras leading 33-0, and as we ended that third quarter, Rochester coughed the football up again, but fortunately they kept possession, and not only did they keep possession, but they gained 6 yards on the fumble recovery.
Yeah, Rochester with 3 fumbles tonight. They've been able to recover all 3 of them and actually gain yardage in the situation. Eastbrook not so fortunate. Their 3 fumbles turn into Rochester's scores.
Yeah. And as we anticipated at halftime, the heat and the humidity causing a little damage for the Rochester Zebras. Harper and Hadeshell left the game a couple of minutes ago with cramps. Wilson Lee is your tailback. Beck is still in the football game. Bennett is wide to the near side. Heckathorn, who's had a good game, is a flanker to the right. 2 times for the Zebras with Hunting under center on 2nd and 4. Heckathorn comes in motion on the jet sweep, gets it coming around the near side. Heckathorn with a sprint at the 15, jumps inside the 15, spins around, gets it to the 10, maybe even down to the 9. It'll be 1st and goal for the Zebras at the 9 after an 19-yard gain for Jay Heckathorn.
Nice run by Heckathorn. He come around the corner of that offensive line. They did a great job of sealing that corner, and there wasn't anybody there. Good job of leading him down the sideline.
Heckathorn comes off the field, as does Kistler. Abbott on the field. And you're probably going to see the 2 tight ends, full house backfield for Rochester, 11:43. It will be from left to right, Lee, Beck, and Abbott, 2 tight ends for the Zebras on 1st and goal from the 9. Hunting with 5 of the play clock, takes the snap, gives to Lee. Lee, right side, wide open path to the end zone, touchdown Zebras.
Wilson Lee untouched to the end zone. Nice job. Good job of blocking by that right side of the offensive line by Rochester.
And another new Zebra scored.
Yeah. 11:30 to play in the ball game. Rochester now up 39-0 with the PAT coming for the Zebras. and Wilson Lee will be doing the honors here. Again, Abbott is your holder. Schaefer, the long snapper. Lee, the right-footed kicker, awaiting the snap from Schaefer. Snap is back, hold is down, kick is away, no good. And but we have a flag in the play. Hold everything. Is that going to be offsides? A flag in the play if it gets Rochester, obviously that'll be declined. But they are talking to the Rochester Zebra captain, Schaefer. It'll be offsides on the defense, and we'll try her again. 11.5 to play in the football game. Rochester attempts the extra point. They miss it. Beesbrook was offside, so we'll try it again. So again, Schaefer, the holder, or the snapper. Snap is down.
Time's a charm.
Hold is down. Snap is away. Kick it away. Good grief. It's good. 40-0, Rochester. 11:30 to play in the game. 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Playing the game, and another new Zebra in the end zone.
Yep, nine plays, 3 minutes, 46 seconds, taking off the clock. Wilson Lee gets his first touchdown of the night, 9 yards, and his own PAT was good.
Wilson Lee, a deep kick to the 20, muffed out there at the 20-yard line, picked it up, and brought down after about a 6-yard gain, or a 6-yard return out to about the 26 or 7-yard line, so that's where Eastbrook will. Yeah,
that's been a nightmare for Eastbrook.
It's been a problem for both teams.
I mean, Rochester, again, with 3 fumbles that they've been able to recover, so it's been a problem for both teams in this first game of the season, but, boy, it's been a nightmare for Eastbrook.
Yeah, I agree. So Eastbrook will take over at their own 26, on the far hash, going to our right. Brad Thomas. Travis Watchering, I'm David Musselman. We're here at Eastbrook High School. Again, home next week with the Plymouth Rockies.
Yep.
Did I do that right?
Yeah, that's pretty close.
Interesting TRC score. Wabash leads Peru 7-6.
Really?
Yeah.
Four receivers for Eastbrook. Two to the left, two to the right. Shotgun for Bennett. Bennett on a jet sweep. Gibson Watson coming to the near side. Watson stops, shifts direction, and cut down to the 30. Giving four. Nice job by the Zebras on the near side. Wilson Lee and Jay Heckethorn stopping for a minimal gain, which could have been, with everybody spread out like that, it could have been huge.
So you're a coach on an opposing team, and you see players going down with cramps across the sidelines. What do you run? Jet sweep. Left, jet sweep right.
That's not very quick scoring, though.
No, but take advantage of your strength.
Out of the shotgun again.
Same play opposite
side. Watson goes in motion left. On the jet sweep, goes left. Shakes one tackler, shakes another tackler. And not a lot there as he might have got back at the line of scrimmage. It'll be third down and 6 for the Eastbrook Panthers.
You're down. Not say jet sweep right?
You're down 40-0.
Look, I didn't tell you.
They didn't gain anything, but they did run the play.
Third and 6 for Eastbrook. Go back to the traditional wing fade look. Wide of the receiver to the near side is Deshaun. Bennett come up under center with 10 on the play clock. Set the line with 10-10 to play in the game. Watson in motion to the near side. Back to pass is Bennett. Here comes the pressure. Steps up. Rolls left. Keeps it. Runs left. Has a first down. Down the far side line to the 40 to 45. And steps out of bounds at about the 46-yard line. And nice job by Bennett. I'm not sure if that was a design quarterback keeper, but because of the pressure, had to step up and decided just to keep it. And it carried it for 17 yards and an Eastbrook first down.
It's his biggest play in the positive side of the field all night.
First and 10 for the Panthers at their own 46-yard line. Ball on the far hash. Bennett quickly on the ball. 20 seconds on the play clock. Under 10 minutes to play in the game. Back to pass again is Bennett. Here comes the pressure. He's drilled as he gets rid of it. It is incomplete.
Oh, wow.
Intended for Wallace on the near side put it right in his breadbasket, couldn't bring it down.
Abbott almost intercepted it. I think Abbott was going for the interception, and Wallace run into his arms.
Was that Shane coming from the far side?
I don't know. Someone drilled him, and Abbott was intercepted.
Yeah, Abbott was right there.
I think that from the far side, Shane came in and just delivered a pop on Bennett as he got rid of the ball just before he got rid of the ball.
Oh, yeah, on the quarterback, right.
Yes. The carry goes to the fullback that crosses the 50 down to around the 49.
What's his number? What's
Elliott with the carry.
Tyler Bennett's number is throwing. What's his completion?
I've got him 4 for 6 for 62.
And they're down 40 and they keep running it. I don't get
three,
it.
Third down and 6 for Eastbrook. Elliott again, right side, has a first down. And Wilson Lee brings him down at the Rochester 40-yard line. And that'll be another Eastbrook first down with 9:27 to play in the game with Rochester up 40-0. Quickly on the ball are the Panthers. Deshaun goes wide to the left side. Wallace, your slot back to the right side. Watkins, your slot back to the left. Fullback here is Elliott. Under center is Bennett. Bennett on the keeper, coming to the near side, looking to flip. Stops, cuts it back inside. Stacked up at the 35. He's going to pick up 5. It'll be 2nd and 5. And I don't think that he wants to flip that ball very fast
anymore. He pretty well run all the way to the sideline at that time. And he did make a smart move and cut back in towards the middle of the field. That's where he had his blockers.
2nd down and 5. Jordan Schaefer goes out of the game.
Westbeck is also out.
Yep. Watson in motion to the near side. Gives to Wallace over the left side. Wallace stacked up by Lee
and
Heckethorn. Nope. And the ball is carried out at the 29. It'll be 1st down and for Eastbrook inside the Rochester 30 with 8:45 to play in the game. Elliott, left side. Well, Elliott, good heavens. Carries literally 5 Eastbrook tacklers with him as he gets it to right around the 20. That's close to another 1st down. So it'll be 2nd and 1 for Eastbrook. Bennett to Elliott, right side, inside the 20. Dragging a couple of tacklers inside the 15, down to around the 12. It'll be a pickup of about 8 yards and another 1st down for the Eastbrook Panthers. Heckethorn's still down. I think he's tying a shoe. He gets up.
I'm surprised he's still in, to be honest.
I've got Elliott with 77 yards in this ball game on 17 carries.
18 carries now. As he gets it down to the 7-yard line. Doing about 6. It'll be 2nd down and, give me 5. It'll be 2nd and 5 for Eastbrook, and they're quickly on the ball. And now we're going to have a stop the play, and Rochester will use a timeout. 7:51 to play. In the football game, Rochester up 40-0. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. third and five. Elliott around the right side. The Zebras stack him up right before he gets to the two-yard line. So give him the three and a pickup of about two. It'll be third down and two for the Eastbrook Panthers as they're getting very close to the end zone for the first time tonight. Quickly on the ball is Bennett. Elliott has been the workhorse this entire drive. He gets it again going right, looking for the end zone. Touchdown, Eastbrook.
Well,
Luke Elliott puts the Eastbrook Panthers on the board for the first time this year, and it's 40-6.
It's just a matter of riding your bread and butter all the way
yep.
to the end zone. Elliott, with the majority of all the carries in that series.
And that comes with 7:26 to play in the game. And the extra point coming for the Panthers.
He gets the distinction of scoring the first Eastbrook touchdown on this brand new field.
That's right.
Which you can see, by the way.
Snap is down, kick is away, and it just sneaks over the crossbar, and it's 40-7. Rochester leads here late in the game. You're listening to Rochester Football, 92.1 WRL. .26 to play in the game. Eastbrook scores for the first time tonight.
I had 11 plays, about 3:45 taken off the clock, capped off by a Luke Elliott 3-yard touchdown run. The PAT was good. Zebras lead 40-7 with 7.5 to go in the fourth quarter.
But Plymouth leading Bremen 35-7 late in the second half.
And last report we've got out of Wabash in the third quarter, the Apaches lead the Peru Tigers 7-6.
I like that.
Yep. So the Zebras will receive the kick.
That'll be a conference game next year.
It's a pooch kick, high, short, picked up by Hunting at the 28. Hunting picking his way through traffic and is brought down to the 36-yard line. So all Rochester wants to do here is eat into that 7 minutes and 20 seconds left in the game, get out of here without anybody getting injured, and put a mark in the win column here at Eastbrook on the turf.
Absolutely.
Wilson Lee will stay in.
Hunting's off.
Brett Abbott will be the quarterback.
Actually.
Wes Beck is in. What?
Oh, no. Hunting's out there. But
Kistler will play as well. 7:21 to play in the game. 40-7 Rochester. Eckethorn still out there. He goes wide to the right side. Bennett split to the near side, the short side of the field. Abbott is your quarterback under center. Split backs behind him with Lee and Beck. Abbott takes a snap, gives to Beck right side. Wes Beck runs over his own player, still fighting for yardage, spins away from a couple of tacklers, still fighting, gets out to the 39, giving three. It's a three tough yard, second down and seven for Rochester.
It keeps the clock running.
Yep. Clock rolls here at Eastbrook. You know, one thing that Coach Zahner told me in the pregame, that he was excited to see Heckathorn return kickoffs and punts, but he was also hopeful that maybe Heckathorn would only return one kickoff. It has been only two tonight. Rochester's played a pretty good game. Ball in the middle of the field. Abbott and company looking second down and seven. Two wideouts, one to the near, one to the far. High backs for the quarterback with 6.5 to play in the game. Lee gets it going left. And Lee is spun down behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to give him the 39. Nothing here. It'll be 3rd and 7 with 6:20 to play in the game.
And there goes Heckathorn.
He's had a fantastic game.
Absolutely.
Defensively and offensively. Schaefer's out of the game. Down to 15 on the play clock. Play just does get to the huddle with 6 minutes to play in the football game.
Heckathorn.
Rensberger wide to the right side. Bennett wide to the near side. High backs for Abbott. Abbott takes a snap. We're going to have a false start on the Rochester Zebras. That'll back him up 5. And that'll bring up 3rd down and about 12 for the Zebras. I think that was Randall Brack that jumped early. So third and 12 for Rochester with 5:48 to play in the game. Rensburger goes split to the right side, Bennett wide to the near side, short side of the field, pulling the near hash. High backs for Abbott. Now ducked up under center. Takes the snap, back to pass. Abbott rolls right, steps up, keeps it, tries to run away from the defense. But I believe that was Reese who grabbed him from behind and brought him down right at the sticks for about a 3-yard gain. It'll bring up fourth down and 9. It was Reese. Great job by Reese. That was a designed run from the word go.
McConaughey leading North Miami 26-12.
At the end of the third quarter, Winnemac leads Knox 40-0.
Wow.
Beck back to punt on 4th and 9. Under 5 to play in the game, a high snap. He brings it down. Here comes a little pressure. Gets it away. And knuckleball down the middle of the field. Picked up at the 36-yard line. It fakes the reverse. Comes to the near side. Is watching. Great block by the Eastbrook Panthers. Watson down to 30. The 25 cuts it back inside of the 20. He's going to the house. Touchdown, Eastbrook. And there's a flag in the play.
Yeah, we got a flag. And an injured zebra. He got lit up.
I don't know that number.
16.
That was a touchdown. That, too, will be brought back. And that play happened 20 yards behind the play.
They threw the flag almost after the touchdown. They're going to call a block in the back at the 40-yard line. And, the ball carrier was inside the 10.
I think Watson might have been in the end zone.
That's Connor McLaughlin, the one who said injured zebra.
And I think Coach Zahner is complaining about it being a shoulder to the chin under the helmet. But it looks as though it's
Garrett Bradley delivered a pretty good block on McLaughlin, who really sprung.
Well, and he come pretty close to getting a taunting call. I mean, that was a terrific block, don't get me wrong.
But he stands there for 5 seconds, like, jumping.
Looking at him,
get the block, go downfield.
Gotta be careful about that kind of thing,
So,
they're going to allow a touchdown, and then the personal foul after the score.
So the touchdown stands, and the touchdown was by Peyton Watson, who carried the ball 60-plus yards. I think he picked it up at the 36-yard line, so that was almost, 64-yard run back.
Which might be the right call. I mean, they didn't throw that flag till after the touchdown, it looked like. Zahner's not questioning it, at least.
Well, he's going to be upset about giving up the return.
Right.
That's for sure.
So Peyton Watson carries the ball, returns the ball 64 yards on the punt return to score. And Zahner's still out discussing the flag. Not happy with the call, but who is ever happy with the call? I don't know why the officials ever do this. Seriously, you're in a no-win situation. You're going to lose your butt every game because of been chewed on so much. Who would do that? Not I. So here comes the point after. Snap is back. Hold is down. Here comes the pressure. It gets the kick away, and it is good. 40-14 Rochester. Back with more to this on 92.1 WROI. To play in the game.
Punt return.
Peyton Watson just put the Eastbrook Panthers on the board again.
64-yard punt return.
And the field point after was good, so Rochester going to get the football.
Onside kick.
I was going to say, the penalty was on Rochester?
That was against Eastbrook.
Yeah, it was on Eastbrook, and that'll back him up. No, wait a minute.
That was on us.
And they signaled it the wrong way. So the personal foul was on Rochester?
Apparently.
So he signaled wrong.
Yeah, he twice. Signaled wrong twice, yeah.
Okay, so Eastbrook scored on the punt, and then Rochester had a personal foul. Whistle against them, which gives Eastbrook a 15-yard penalty, which now they'll kick at the Rochester 45-yard line instead of kicking from their own 40.
Just put it in the end zone.
Or you would think that.
On the side.
Yeah.
On the end.
High end over end kick. And Hunting watches it go over his head into the end zone. And so the Zebras will start at the 20 with 4:39 to play in the game, leading 40-14.
Well, I don't know what happened there, but.
Well, and the injured Zebra was on the field for that kickoff. So
McLaughlin, okay.
Yeah.
That's good. He's also a two-way player.
He's not going to be playing offense, so.
Abbott will come back on to run the show. Rensberger will be a receiver. Bennett is also a receiver for the Rochester Zebras. They'll start at their own 40 on this drive. I think they're missing somebody.
Well, did somebody go in for McLaughlin?
Down to 20 on the play clock.
There goes somebody. You'll have to forgive us. Some of these numbers are not on our roster, so.
Abbott under center with five. He's got plenty of time. Takes the snap. Gives to the fullback. All right, up the middle. Gets 20. Gets a yard. Will be second and one.
Yeah, next week when we're home against Plymouth, I think we'll get a better roster.
Clock continues to roll with 4:15 to play in the game. Rochester up 40-14. It'll be second and nine for the Zebras at the at their own 21. Bennett wide to the near side. Rensberger split right. Abbott will be under center. Split back behind him. Abbott down to five on the play clock. Takes a snap with three. Gives to the fullback again.
Wilson Lee.
Oh, Lee that time?
Yep.
And Lee might have gotten one. It'll be second and eight. 3:45 to play in the game. Again, next week, Rochester is home with Plymouth. And the Rockies will stay on the Rochester schedule next year.
Plymouth winning big tonight as well.
Yep. John Glenn will take the place of Eastbrook next year's schedule. Pioneer beat Lewis Cass 34-18 tonight.
Wow.
Yes. I think that's a while.
Wow.
Out of back to pass, here comes the pressure. Stiff's arm away from the defense. Now it's trying to run away from the defense. Lowers his head, cuts it back inside. He's spun around inside, outside the 30 to the 31, and that'll be enough for a Zebra first down.
Nice job by Abbott.
What turned into a 9-yard gain, well, actually, what could have been a 5-yard loss turned into a 9-yard gain, so give you 14. Can we do that?
Yeah. Give him at least 10, though.
Yeah.
Me. Were you that fast in high school?
Oh, I can still run that fast. 3 minutes to play in the game, right, Kennedy?
I think I saw an eye roll.
Ball at the 31 for the Zebras, the straight T backfield. Make that Abbott under center. To Lee. Lee is wrestled down to the 30, loses the yard. It'll be second and 11 with under 3 to play in the game. Second down. And long with 2:40 to play in the game. Actually, they're going to give you no gain. It'll be second and 10. We're at Rochester up 40-14 here at Eastbrook High School with 2.5 minutes to play in the game. Brad Thomas, Travis Watering. I'm David Musselman. Facility's fantastic.
Yeah.
Hospitality's been fantastic.
Yep.
But the field is fantastic.
It's a beautiful place.
Yep,
to play
I agree.
Football game.
But I won't miss the hour and a half drive.
Well, that's true. Don't miss the bill that took them to put this in either.
No.
Abbott on the quarterback keeper pushes his way to the 34. 2 minutes to play in the game. Actually, it's not a bad price tag because they're going to have that anyway or close to it that they put in the soccer field.
Right.
They had to redo their field anyway with new sprinkler system and all that.
New track.
Yeah. It's going to be close to the same bill anyway. I'm just glad I don't have to pay it.
Not signing that check.
Yeah.
Great.
A minute 40 to play in the game. third down and 7 for the Zebras, just shy of the 35. Abbott, with two tight ends in the full house backfield, takes the snap. With 3 on the play clock, gives to Wilson Lee. Wilson Lee in the backfield and is spinning, gets him across the 35 to the 36, giving 2. That'll bring up 4th and 5 for the Zebras with 1:15 to play in the game. And I've got to imagine that I think they're going to go for it, to tell you the truth. Either that or they're going to try to draw them off sides. But the ball will be at their own 36-yard line. They're looking at 4th and 5, down to 1 minute to play in the game.
I thought Gavin Bennett had a couple good routes tonight where, you could throw the ball to him, and we'll see if Abbott is going to get that opportunity.
Coach Mike Zahner will use a timeout. We will, too. You're listening to Zebra Football, 92.1 WROI. Playing the game, Rochester up 40-14, and it's 4th down and 4. Zebras will look like they'll keep the offense on. West Central will be calling tonight 34-0. I think Paul Hettinger for those scores tonight with Winamac and West Central. Under center is Abbott at the own 36 with 37 to play in the game. Abbott fakes the handoff, rolls on the near side, rolls away from pressure. He's got a wide open field. He's got a first down. Abbott at the 50, outside at the 45, the 40. Key is still pushing his way down to the 36 with Eastbrook. A huge gain for Abbott and a first down, and probably that'll put Zebras in the victory formation.
I'll give him 25 on the pickup. That sounds about right.
Yeah, I'd say almost like a 29.
Okay. We can do that.
So 28 seconds to play in the game. Clock rolls. Rochester will have to run one more play. It looks like they will be. Well, they're actually going to line up with two tight ends and a straight deep backfield. Abbott will have to snap the ball with about 3 on the play or on the game clock. He's under center, takes a snap, takes a knee, and that'll do it. The final tonight from Eastbrook, the Rochester Zebras defeat the Panthers 40-14. Back to the postgame show after this on 92.1 WROI.